Everything is bigger here. It's more of an emergency because they come in very late when it's already very progressed. And we see everything. Like everything you see back home, you see here, but then in a late stage and without diagnostics.
Malnutrition is mainly, it's also here. It's often a bit more in the villages. What is really nice with malnourished is that actually the moment, if they are not really, really sick, they can improve really fast.
Here you just have a patient, your eyes, your hands and your stethoscope, and you need to make a decision what to do and what you think it is. Type of patients has not been changed so much, but it's more the entire context. So when I came, it was also the hospital was full of displaced people. Also in the beginning, the two religions were still mixed. So we had as well Muslim as Christian patients in our hospital.
There have been quite some attacks on villages, and then you would love to go there, but often it's just still too dangerous.
So just before I came, all the Christian population went into the Evishane, because they felt insecure in Bosangoa and in the surrounding villages. There were a lot of attacks at villages and in town, and this is where they felt safe. We've had some incidents in the hospital as well. Also the 5th of December, there's been shooting inside the hospital. At one point they actually walked past our building, so everyone was just holding their breath to kind of catch by voices which group it was. Because at that time we were still mixed, so for the people in there it was like, are they after me or are they after the one who's sitting next to me? So it was really intense and everyone was just scared. Yeah. No. We have staff from both religions who work nice together, and we have a fantastic team, and they're part of this team. And suddenly they just have to leave because they are Muslim and they're not safe anymore, and they're all leaving, and you can't stay behind as the last Muslim in a place where people are actually trying to kill you now and then.
Yeah, what's left of such a country right now, you know? This is their place where they are supposed to be, and it's just one such a war that is tearing people apart. And yeah, and that just makes it very, very sad.